Everybody, here we go. Let's drop the motor down. I forgot to do that. There we go. Well, so far, I mean, it seems pretty stable. I can't wait to open her up.
Do it
because outboard motors are supposed to have a break-in period. Now the shop told me that they already broke it in because they ran it for a few hours, but I'm like, I still don't want to take their word for it. I'd rather still idle it, because what they can do is set the motor up inside a bucket with water and they just put it on idle and let it run for 2 hours. Not that I don't trust them, I just don't want to ruin a $4,000 motor. I tell you what, it's a lot easier backing up helicopters into the barn in the squadron. Back in my day, used to back those helicopters up. You had a very long tow bar, so it made it super easy. With a small trailer, it's a little bit harder, so you gotta turn the wheel a lot. And if you ain't got a good turning radius on your truck, then it's very hard to do. All right. Let's kill the motor. It's a nice good break-in time. And we will put it straight so that we know that whenever we're drifting, that skeg down there on the lower unit is going to help us to keep our direction. But right now what we're going to do is just try and see if I can push pull this thing, like what kind of control I have. We'll use the kayak paddle for right now because that's all I got, and see if we can get my son on any fish. Yeah, it's pretty deep, about 5 feet, something like that. Very impressed with the stability of it. So I'm 180 pounds. My son's probably 2-something. And then we got a little bit of our gear. We came out here bare bones for the most part. And she handles well. I really didn't want to have to put the Minn Kota, the spot lock motor, the Riptide one. But I think I'm gonna have to invest in that. That's just right now for deep water, just so that we can troll around, so you don't have to run the outboard on idle, because then we're gonna spook the fish every time.
How much do those cost?
About $1,400. Yeah, it's pretty expensive. Tough pill to swallow. But if you want to run in the bayous, like the main bayous, and fish alongside the grass line, then I guess we're going to have no choice but to do that. Did a battery swap, and we're going to start push-pulling this girl. Get her closer to the bank. Water level is pretty high, so that's a good plus for us while we're breaking in the motor. So I want to address one thing. I've been getting a lot of questions about concerns not using the kayak anymore. Don't worry, once the honeymoon is over with the skiff, then we'll go back to an even mix of videos, try to keep it even with the kayak and the micro skiff. So I'm not gonna abandon the kayak at all. Man, I really got to get the push pole. It's going to be a must. Yeah, once we get a chance to get to Corpus, then we can visit those guys over there. Because this is for the birds. I can't even touch the bottom. The push pole is supposed to be like twice the length of this paddle. I think a trolling motor is going to be a must. I'm just gonna call it.
I
am. It's such a great tool. What I really didn't want to do was put holes in it up there at front. But I think even if we had the trolling motor up there, the front person can still use the platform to cast from. I think, like, plus if we had the trolling motor on here, the trolling motor prop is cheaper to replace. If we hit oyster, it's going to be the warning before the bottom of the skiff actually hits. So I know my autopilot trolling motor, which is going to be the same exact one that I would get for the skiff, it can take a beating. I mean, I put that thing through some abuse. So I'm pretty sure the question that some people are going to think about is like, okay, so if you're by yourself, how is it maneuvering yourself, like moving yourself from the rear where the polling platform is that I'm sitting on? Uh-oh. Oh, Christian's on. That's the it got off. You got to set that hook a little bit harder. Tighten up your drag.
Oh my.
It's so loose. That was going to be the first fish in the micro skiff. Well, you got the thump. Is your drag tight? Not.
It's been so long. I got to pull it up at mean here.
Let me see.
Would have probably been a red.
Oh man, like a red. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's perfect. The other thing about this micro skiff is it is the same size as a kayak. It does not look like it. I know the photos and the video doesn't kind of show that, but it definitely is the same size as a kayak. It's 13 foot long. So a solo skiff is 14. I think the beam is 45 inches, but the solo skiff beam is 43, something like that. So it is the same size as a kayak, but the space, you know, they make good use of the space on this thing. Yeah, this ain't working. Yeah, we have an outgoing tide, so the current is going out towards the bay, and the wind is in our favor, but it's too tough to paddle this. Once we get to the bank, it'll be a lot easier for me to push it. All right, so I'm gonna break this in half, son, and
No.
What we're gonna do is just start motoring. We'll motor ourselves out of the way. We'll try to get to a back lake or something. I can see that one right there, but I don't know how to get to it. Oh, you got him?
No.
Oh. So you set the hook, just set the hook one time. If you didn't get it good, you do it another time, but that's it. Don't keep doing it. Twice is more than enough in case you feel that you didn't get a good hook set the first time. And then just be patient. Either you're gonna feel the tension or not, because if you keep trying to set that hook, you're gonna rip it from their mouth. All right, so now I can turn the skiff around and the wind is blowing us into this bank. That's fine, I'm good with that. I'll just keep push-pulling us. This is so much easier to go with the current as the tide is going out, because the wind is keeping us right here against the grass and then the current is helping me to just move. So all I'm doing is just guiding the boat. I want to get over there. You see where the ditch, the drain is? In front of you, 12 o'clock.
What's that? Is it just water?
Yeah, it's the windblown water and the other water is protected.
I see jar right there.
that's where I want to get to, that drain right over there. Oh my gosh.
Nice.
Son, first cast.
Nice.
And what is it going to, it's going to be,
that's a big old trout.
That's a good trout. And it's a keeper trout. There we go. Right in the boat. Awesome. Got our first keeper fish. It's a speckled trout inside the boat. We'll get you off, buddy, really fast. You know what? Oh, you don't have your phone, do you?
You got it up there.
It's okay. We'll get a photo from this footage. Spectacular speckled trout. It's borderline keeper. I mean, yeah, that's 15 inches, don't you think?
He's right.
Oh.
He's right there.
Yeah, he's on the brink. Let's get him.
It felt just, that bite right there felt just like what it felt like when they took my freaking tail.
All right, buddy. Oh my gosh. Impatient, dude.
Yeah, that's not good.
Huh? Yeah, I don't think it's 10 as well. It's really tough to push pull against it. Even though the current is going out, I got no control. Oh,
that's one.
That looks like a flounder. Is it?
Oh, maybe a flounder.
Oh, it's a flounder. Okay, don't reel no more. Hold on. There we go. Working on, oh, look at that. It just popped out.
I really could set the hook because I thought, it feels just like you're freaking dipping in the mud.
Yeah. Hold on, little Billy. Oh my God, we got James Brown down here. This turned out to be a very successful maiden voyage for us, son. There we go. All right, so we just did the battery swap. Christian's got him inside the water. And we are gonna let this fella go. Look how gorgeous this is. Let me get the hat over there.
Just get him out the shade.
Yeah, spectacular. We got two fish. We just need a red. And the release. Straight back down to the bottom that fella goes. It is super tough. First day observations on the micro skiff. Very tough to control it. We got like 12, maybe 14 plus mile an hour winds out of the east, and they are affecting me really bad. To the skiff's credit, I'm not using an actual pole, so it makes it really hard without having that length. The pole that I would be using is going to be double the size of the paddle that we actually are trying to use. It's my kayak paddle, and I just can't really get any forward momentum going, so we're trying to stay close to the edge and push ourselves along. But we're almost at the end of our trip. We got to start heading back in, run the motor at idle. Not idle, it's like a maybe 50% is what I've opened her up to so far, and it's barely starting to get plane. We got the kayak pushed to the max as far as weight goes. I think we're actually exceeding the weight limit of it, but it's a champ and it's holding steady. Feels perfect, not wobbly in the least, and we're both fishing, and it's just a spectacular platform so far. First observations, we can't pass any judgment just quite yet. I'm leaning towards, based off of the performance thus far, the first hour, 2 hours that we've been out here, I'm leaning towards getting the autopilot, the Minn Kota, not the autopilot, I'm sorry, the Minn Kota Riptide with that spot lock technology. So that's what it seems like so far. Let's continue fishing and then we'll make our way out of here. Pretty rough. Got it? Okay, that's good.
And that is it. The maiden voyage is in the books. Able to catch the two fish. It would have been awesome if we would have been able to catch the red for the slam. But we just ran out of time. The winds were pretty horrible. On our way back, we did take a few swells over the side on the gunwales, but it was nothing that the skiff couldn't handle. Everything felt safe. No like tippiness or anything like that, but we did keep our center of gravity over the center of the skiff itself, and it just performed really well. Pushed it at about 50%. We're not gonna open her up until, like, I don't know, maybe, I thought like after two more trips, but it may take a little bit longer than that. I'm not too sure. I'm gonna get on Mercury's website. The dealer told me that I did not have to worry about it. Just stay 50%. You can even try to go 75, somewhere around there. I can't remember. I have to watch the footage and then give him a call just to try to find out exactly what it was that he said, because all I was concerned about was just getting the skiff itself, being happy that we finally got it, and I wasn't thinking about anything else. So I will find that out so that we can truly open her up safely and see what she's truly capable of doing. But very stable. I'm loving it. 13 foot long, 45 inches wide, and it handles, I'm not gonna say it handles like a kayak, because that would be a lie, because if it handled like a kayak, I would be able to paddle it, and you cannot do that. So we're either gonna have to get a stiffy push pole from Carpentex, I think it's Carpentex Marine out of Corpus, or we will go the route of a Minn Kota autopilot, the Riptide trolling motor up at the bow. I don't know yet. I'm leaning towards a trolling motor though, but let's put a few more trips underneath her belt. Yeah, that's it. That's gonna do it. Thank y'all so much for tagging along on this adventure. I really appreciate it. Because of y'all, I get to do things like this. And before I end, I am gonna throw a mega shout out to all the supporters of the channel, all you subscribers, but most importantly to my patrons. Without y'all's dedicated support, this never would have happened. So I saved and pinched pennies for a good while, and this right there are the fruits of that labor, providing y'all with as much as I possibly can, and in return donating to the channel is it just means the world to me. So thank you so much from the bottom of my heart to each and every one of y'all that had a hand in us finally upgrading to something that's still kayak-like. I appreciate it. All right, so that's gonna do it. Until next time, tight lines, y'all.